ever wanted to be an astrophotographer, but the struggles of buying a camera and its accessories have always brought you down? Well, look no further, because today I'm showing you the cheapest and easiest way to do astrophotography. Hello, hello everyone, it's Daily Space Observations and welcome back to another video. And today, I'll be teaching you that astrophotography isn't always done with just a DSLR camera. Unlike what you've seen on magazines and pictures of DSLR cameras and telescopes, it's actually not hard to do astrophotography with your smartphone, and you can actually get some quality pictures out of it. So today, I'll be showing you how to do astrophotography with your given smartphone, which it could be Android or Apple or Samsung, any kind of smartphone. So don't forget to subscribe, leave a like, and turn on that notification bell so that you won't miss any of my latest videos. And without further ado, let's just jump into it. So for your first accessory, you'll need to attach your phone to the telescope. You'll need the smartphone adapter. And this, it allows you to attach your phone to your telescope's eyepiece, which allows you to take pictures. I recommend the Gosky Universal Smartphone Adapter. I actually made a video on adapters and attaching cameras, so I will have that video in the description. And I do recommend this. It is the most popular one on Amazon. It's not the only one. Celestron does make their own too, so I will also have both of those links in the description too if you want to buy either of these. So let's go ahead. So first, what you want to do is you're going to want to just slide it onto the eyepiece, and then with the knob up top here, you're going to want to either twist it, either loosen it or tighten it so that the adapter will be firmly attached to the eyepiece. So now it is. That was step number one complete. Perfect. Now time to use the smartphone. So what you're going to want to do is place the smartphone in the holder here, and with the knob on the side, just loosen it or tighten it on the phone so that your phone is secured in the holder so that it won't fall out. All right, so I'm just tightening it. Oh. In this case, I have an iPhone XR, but the adapter does work with most phones of size. All right, so I have it attached to the eyepiece now. What else should I do? Well, I'll tell you. So what you're gonna wanna do is open your camera and see. I don't think you can see this. Maybe you can, but there is a little thing here. And so what you're gonna wanna do, and this does take a few days to really get the hang of, so don't worry if it's hard. It happens to the best of us. So what you're gonna wanna do is try to get this bright circle in the middle, center it, kind of. And use the knob on the back if you want to move the phone's position in the adapter, or just slide it up or down in the smartphone holder here. So now that that's done, what you should do is just hold it back up. Oh, not completely in yet. This could take a while to really do. Like, at first this took me half an hour. Now it takes me a little less than a minute, a little more. All right, so now I have it centered, all ready to do some astrophotography and imaging. So there is one more additional and optional step that you might want to take, and I will show you that right now. So if you're willing to spend a little bit more money and would like to make this the best astrophotography experience for smartphone ever, then I do have a suggestion. That is a Bluetooth and wireless remote release controller. And what this does is it allows you to remotely take pictures from your smartphone without actually having to touch your smartphone. This can save you all the shaky pictures and videos that That could happen if you would touch the camera button on the smartphone. So, I'm sure you probably know how to connect a Bluetooth device to a phone or tablet, but I'll just do it right now. Because why not? All right. This could take a while. So, of course, go on settings, go on Bluetooth, and here, it's called AB Shutter 3. So if you see a device indiscoverable called AB Shutter 3, that is the remote release. So just click on that and it should connect. Perfect. So now I have it connected. It even comes with a wristband too. I will have a link for this in the description, of course. So now that that's done, I can wirelessly take pictures. I'm not sure if you can see it. Here, it's facing directly. I just took a picture. I'm not sure if you can see it. I'm sorry about that. But, yeah, that's it. So this is the complete smartphone setup for astrophotography. So, yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. And look at that. The moon's up. I might as well take some pictures with my brand new setup. I hope you like them.